Isaiah chapter 53, verse number 3-5. For he's despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrow and acquainted with grief. We hid our faces from him, and he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. We esteemed him as stricken, smitten of God, afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we were healed. Malachi chapter 4, verse number 2. But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go forth and grow up as calves in the stall. One translation says, but for you who revere my name, the Son of Righteousness will arise with healing in his beams, and you'll go forth and leap like calves from the stall. I believe right now God's releasing you from your beds of affliction. He's releasing you from the chains of your disease. For the Son of Righteousness is arising with healing in his wings. Matthew chapter 8, verse number 2-3. Behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou can make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will. Be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. One translation says, if you have the will, Lord, you have the power. Jesus said, I have the will, be cleansed. Matthew 8, verse number 16-17. When the evenings come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils. And he cast out the spirits with his word, and he healed all that were sick, that it might be fulfilled by that which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, he himself took our infirmities, and he bare our sicknesses. The New English Bible says he took away our illnesses, and he lifted our diseases from us. Matthew 9, 34-35. But the Pharisees said, he cast out devils through the prince of devils. And Jesus went about in all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. For Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That means that what Jesus did in the Bible, he's doing today in your life. Mark 5, 25-34. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood for 12 years and had suffered many things of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was none better, but rather grew worse, when she had heard of Jesus, she came and pressed in behind him and touched his garments. For she said, if I but touch his clothes, I know I shall be made whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And the disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude around you, and you said, who touched me? And he looked around about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what she had done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said to her, daughter, thy faith has made you whole. Go in peace and be whole of your disease. One translation says, go and enjoy your new health. Be free from the trouble that was your scourge in life. Mark 16:17, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils, and they shall speak with new tongues. One translation says, and these attesting miracles will accompany those who believe. They will take up serpents. If they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover.